Yeah, I got into the Stones when I was about 17. What I do really stems from what they do. It's, I guess they're a huge part of my musical vocabulary.
Cher's a good girl, man.
Lovely looking, lovely singing.
I think she's a very good performer. She looks very good as well.
You know, when she opens the show, she's really good.
Good guitar player too. And, you find people that are compatible.
The thing about Cheryl is that she's not very used to performing without the guitar. I mean, you know, that's the thing. So when she comes out and does a duet with me, without and it's a duet and it's without the guitar, I think it's really tricky for her, but she's kind of used to it. The first time she did it, it was fantastic.
It just was a fun and funny evening, and when I went out to sing, Mick was just in rare form, and at one point he had lifted me off the ground, by my butt, basically.
The shock on her face was great.
She just didn't know what to do. I mean, it was in front of a huge audience, and she just stood there, like, and I was going, fuck, she's like really doesn't know what's going on.
And Daryl Jones, bass player, and Lisa Fisher were just like, what?
It's very difficult sometimes to perform with Mick. He can sort of, he doesn't mean to, but because of who and what he is and how good he is at what he does, you can be lost up there.
It was just funny. It was just like a big flirt, but it was perfect for the song, and the crowd was really into it. And
she's one of the few people who can do it.
You kind of find these things out by trial and error. I mean, I don't think the first time we worked with Cheryl it was any deliberate sort of, oh, that would be great. We just found out that it kind of complemented each other.
I don't know, there's some kind of magic chemistry there which works. I like the feel that she has.
Because she's a raunchy girl, you know. She can hold her own amongst guys, you know.